الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر كبيرا.
Please straighten the rows. Make sure there is no gap in the row. Feet, feet, shoulders, shoulders, don't leave any gaps. Allahu Akbar. 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 Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Ar-Rahmanir Rahim. مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم سبح اسم ربك الأعلى الذي خلق فسوى والذي قدر فهدى والذي أخرج المرعى فجعله غثاء أحوى سنقرئك فلا تنسى إلا ما شاء الله إنه يعلم الجهر وما يخفى ونيسرك لليسرى فذكر إن نفعت الذكرى سيذكر من يخشى ويتجنبها الأشقى الذي يصلى النار الكبرى ثم لا يموت فيها ولا يحيا قد أفلح من تزكى وذكر اسم ربه فصلى بل تؤثرون الحياة الدنيا والآخرة خير وأبقى إن هذا لفي الصحف الأولى صحف إبراهيم وموسى. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده Allahu Akbar. 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 بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم هل أتاك حديث الغاشية وجوه يومئذ خاشعة عاملة ناصبة تصلى نارا حامية تسقى من عين آنية ليس لهم طعام إلا من ضريع لا يسمن ولا يغني من جوع وجوه يومئذ ناعمة لسعيها راضية في جنة عالية لا تسمع فيها لاغية فيها عين جارية فيها سرر مرفوعة وأكواب موضوعة ونمارق مصفوفة وزرابي مبثوثة أفلا ينظرون إلى الإبل كيف خلقت وإلى السماء كيف رفعت وإلى الجبال كيف نصبت وإلى الأرض كيف سطحت فذكر إنما أنت مذكر لست عليهم بمسيطر إلا من تولى وكفر فيعذبه الله العذاب الأكبر إن إلينا إيابهم ثم إن علينا حسابهم. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. لك الحمد. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر ولله الحمد. First and foremost, we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for giving us the opportunity to witness this blessed day, the day of Eid, the day of An-Nahr, the day of sacrifice. This is the day that reminds us the symbol of sacrifice. Sayyiduna Ibrahim Khalilullah alayhi salatu wa salam, who gave the greatest sacrifice for the sake of Allah dhul jalali wal ikram. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala showed him in his dream that he was sacrificing, he was slaughtering his son. And then when he told his dream to his son said, Ya Aba tif'al ma tu'mar, satajiduni insha'allahu min as-sabirin. O dear father, do whatever you have seen in the dream, whatever you have been instructed to do. If'al ma tu'mar, satajiduni insha'allahu min as-sabirin. Verily, you will find me amongst those who are patient. And then both of them, the father and son, they were ready to sacrifice. The father was ready to slaughter and the son was ready to be slaughtered. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called upon Ibrahim and he said, قَدْ صَدَّقْتَ الرُّؤْيَا إِنَّا كَذَلِكَ نَيْزِ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. Ibrahim, you have fulfilled your dream and now we are going to stop here. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him and granted him the ram from paradise, and Ibrahim Khalilullah alayhi salatu wasalam, he slaughtered that. And since that day, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made this sacrifice the part of the religion of Islam, which is the only religion accepted by Allah dhul jalali wal ikram. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam used to commemorate this sacrifice every year by slaughtering certain animals. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam also set the highest example of sacrifice when he alayhi salatu wasalam performed his hajj. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam sacrificed 100 camels for the sake of Allah dhul jalali wal ikram. And this sacrifice actually reminds us that in order for us to be successful in our life, we must be ready to sacrifice. Looking at the seerah of Sayyiduna Ibrahim Khalilullah alayhi salatu wasalam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tested him and he was tested with many trials and tribulations. And Allah says in the Quran, وَإِذِ ابْتَلَى إِبْرَاهِيمَ رَبُّهُ بِكَلِمَاتٍ فَأَتَمَّهُنْ. Remember when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tested Ibrahim with so many things and he was successful in every single test, in every single trial, and every single test and trial required him to sacrifice. So he sacrificed the love of his father. He sacrificed the love of his home country. He sacrificed the love of his wife. He sacrificed the love of his son. He sacrificed the love of anything and everything for the love of Allah dhul jalali wal ikram. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him the title of imam. When Allah says, Inni ja'iluka linnasi imama. Now Ibrahim, you have been successful in every single trial and test. Now I give you this title of being Imam. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised him. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised him that every single prophet and messenger who will come after you, they will all be from your progeny. And even the Imamul Anbiya, Sayyidul Imam, Sayyidul Anbiya, Sayyidul Thaqalain, Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was also from the progeny of Sayyiduna Ibrahim, Khalilullah alayhi salatu wa salam. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told us in the Quran, فَاتَّبِعُوا مِلَّةَ إِبْرَاهِيمَ حَنِيفًا. Follow the footsteps and the path and the way of Ibrahim Khalilullah alayhi salatu wa salam. So Muslims, O believers, O the followers of Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, there is great lesson for you in the life of Sayyiduna Ibrahim Khalilullah alayhi salatu wa salam. And the greatest lesson is that if you truly want to be successful in this dunya as well as in the hereafter, then you must remain firm and steadfast the way Ibrahim Khalilullah alayhi salatu wasalam was firm and steadfast. And in order for you to remain firm and steadfast, you must be ready to sacrifice anything and everything for the sake of Allah Dhul Jalal Ikram. Without sacrifice, you cannot remain firm. And without being firm, you can never succeed in your life. And in addition to this, whenever you sacrifice anything for the sake of Allah Dhul Jalal wal Ikram, remember, you are not going to do any favor to your Lord. Rather, you must remain thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran that one of the outstanding characteristics and the qualities of Sayyiduna Ibrahim Khalilullah alayhi salatu wasalam was that after all these trials and tests and tribulations, Ibrahim remained thankful servant to Allah Dhul Jalali wal Ikram. He sacrificed everything, yet he remained thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah says, Shakiran li an'umih, ijtabahu wa hadahu ila siratin mustaqim. Ibrahim was the one who was thankful to the favors of Allah Dhul Jalal wal Ikram. So as a believer, as a Muslim, there are great lessons for us in the life of Sayyiduna Ibrahim Khalilullah alayhi salatu wasalam. So bear in mind, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, no matter how many trials and tribulations you face in your life, you must remain firm and steadfast on your deen, on your iman, on the tawheed of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, believing in Allah Dhul Jalal wal Ikram, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's assistance and help is always for the believers. Inna nasrallahi qareeb. Never despair the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and be ready to sacrifice anything and everything for the sake of Allah Dhul Jalal wal Ikram. Then eventually Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant you success in this dunya as well as in the hereafter. So on this special occasion, the occasion of Eid, we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He Dhul Jalali wal Ikram has blessed us with so many favors and bounties, to the extent that if we were to even try to count the favors of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we'll never be able to count the favors of Allah Dhul Jalali wal Ikram upon us. So we must remain thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also, we must make dua to Allah Dhul Jalal wal Ikram that He subhanahu wa ta'ala grants us firmness and steadfastness on our deen and on our iman, so that we remain successful in this dunya as well as in the hereafter. And finally, I take this opportunity to congratulate every one of you on this special occasion, and we conclude by making dua to Allah Dhul Jalal wal Ikram. Rabbana atina fi dunya hasanatan wa fil akhirati hasanatan wa qina adhab an-nar. ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين. ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب. ربنا إننا سمعنا مناديا ينادي للإيمان أن آمنوا بربكم فآمنا. ربنا فاغفر لنا ذنوبنا وكفر عنا سيئاتنا وتوفنا مع الأبرار. ربنا وآتنا ما وعدتنا على رسلك ولا تخزنا يوم القيامة إنك لا تخلف الميعاد. ربنا اغفر لنا ولإخواننا الذين سبقونا بالإيمان ولا تجعل في قلوبنا غلا للذين آمنوا ربنا إنك رؤوف رحيم. اللهم يا فاطر السماوات والأرض أنت ولينا في الدنيا والآخرة توفنا مسلمين وألحقنا بالصالحين. اللهم يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك وطاعتك. And I will also request the brothers and sisters to make dua for our beloved brother who has passed away yesterday, Brother Barry Shafi. So please remember him in your dua. The burial is not announced yet, and the janazah and funeral is not announced yet. But please remember him in your dua, and all those Muslims who have passed away on Tawheed and the Iman, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive their sins, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow them entry into paradise. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all success in this dunya and in the hereafter. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gather us all in Jannatul Firdaus al-A'la with our beloved Nabi Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Innahu sami'un qareebun mujib. Subhanak Allahumma wa bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa ant. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Subhana rabbika rabbil izzati amma yasifun. Wasalamun ala al-mursaleen. Walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.
Thank you. Thank you.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر كبيرا والحمد لله كثيرا وسبحان الله بكرة وأصيلا وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله